Well, why don't we begin? It's 8 o'clock. Welcome, everybody. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. I was glad when they said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. At page 79, let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess that we have sinned against you
in thought, word, and deed.
By what we have done, and by what we have left undone.
We have not loved you with our whole heart.
We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves.
We are truly sorry. And we humbly repent.
And we humbly repent of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, and forgive us, and in your will, in your ways, glory in your name.
Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips.
And our mouths shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father,
and to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now,
and will be forever. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Susan, could I put you on the spot and ask you to read the Vanity, please?
Sure. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice.
Amen.
Psalm appointed for day is Psalm 72. That can be found at page 685. Page 685. 72nd Psalm. Give the king your justice, O God.
And your righteousness to the king's son.
That he may rule your people righteously.
And the poor with justice.
That the mountains may bring prosperity to the people.
And the little hills bring righteousness.
He shall defend the needy among the people.
He shall rescue the poor and the oppressor.
He shall live as long as the sun and moon endure.
From one generation to another.
He shall come down like rain upon the mown field.
Like showers upon the earth.
In his time shall the righteous flourish.
There shall be abundance of beasts, but the moon shall be no more.
He shall rule from sea to sea.
And from the river to the end of the earth.
His foes shall bow down before him.
And his enemies shall lick dust.
Kings of Tarshish and of the Isles shall pay tribute.
And the kings of Arabia shall offer gifts.
All kings shall bow down before him.
And all the nations do him service.
For he shall deliver the poor who cries out in distress.
And the oppressed who has no helper.
Shall have pity on the lowly and poor.
He shall preserve the lives of the needy.
He shall redeem their lives from oppression and violence.
And dear shall their blood excite.
Long may he live, and may there be given to him gold from Arabia.
May prayer be always. And may they bless him all the day long.
May there be abundance of grain on the earth, growing thick even on the hilltops.
May its fruit fresh like Lebanon, rain like grass upon the earth.
May his name remain forever and be established as long as the sun endures.
May all the nations bless themselves in him and call him blessed.
Blessed be the Lord God, the God of Israel,
who alone does wondrous deeds.
And blessed be his glorious name forever.
And may all the earth fill with his glory. Amen. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son,
and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning,
is now, and forever.
Amen. Amen.
We'll have our readings, and Beth is going to offer our readings. In between, we'll have the canticle for today, sung by some awesome choir somewhere. And the canticle, if you want to follow along and read, is Canticle 11 at page 87. And you can put yourself on mute until after the Apostles' Creed.
A reading from Judges. The Israelites again did what was evil in the sight of the Lord. And the Lord strengthened King Eglon of Moab against Israel, because they had done what was evil in the sight of the Lord. In alliance with the Ammonites and Amalekites, he went and defeated Israel, and they took possession of the city of palms. So the Israelites served King Eglon of Moab for 18 years. But when the Israelites cried out to the Lord raised up for them a deliverer, Ehud, son of Gera, the Benjaminite, a left-handed man. The Israelites sent tribute by him to King Eglon of Moab. Ehud made for himself a sword with two edges, a cubit in length, and he fastened it on his right thigh under his clothes. Then he presented the tribute to King Eglon of Moab. Now Eglon was a very fat man. When Ehud had finished presenting the tribute, he sent the people who carried the tribute on their way. But he himself turned back to the sculptured stones near Gilgal and said, "I have a secret message for you, O king." So the king said, "Silence," and all of his attendants went out from his presence. Ehud came to him while sitting alone in his cool roof chamber and said, "I have a message from God for you." So he rose from his seat. Then Ehud reached with his left hand, took the sword from his right thigh, and thrust it into Eglon's belly. The hilt also went in after the blade, and the fat closed over the blade, for he did not draw the sword out of his belly, and the dirt came out. Then Ehud went out into the vestibule and closed the doors of the roof chamber on him and locked them. After he had gone, the servants came. When they saw that the doors of the roof chamber were locked, they thought, "He must be relieving himself in the cool chamber." So they waited until they were embarrassed. When he still did not open the doors of the roof chamber, they took the key and opened them. There was their Lord lying dead on the floor. He had escaped while they delayed and passed beyond the sculptured stones and escaped to Syrah. When he arrived, he sounded the trumpet in the hill country of Ephraim. And the Israelites went down with him from the hill country, having him at their head. He said to them, "Follow after me, for the Lord has given your enemies, the Moabites, into your hand." So they went down after him and seized the fords of the Jordan against the Moabites and allowed no one to cross over. At that time, they killed about 10,000 of the Moabites, all strong, able-bodied men. No one escaped. So Moab was subdued that day under the hand of Israel, and the land had rest for 80 years. Here ends the reading.
Thank you.
A reading from Matthew. From noon on, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. And about 3:00, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani," that is, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, "This man is calling for Elijah." At once one of them ran and got a sponge, filled it with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink. But the other said, "Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him." Then Jesus cried again with a loud voice and breathed his last. At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. The earth shook and the rocks were split. The tombs also were opened, and many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were dead, were raised. After his resurrection, they came out of the tombs and entered the holy city and appeared to many. Now when the centurion and those with him who were keeping watch over Jesus saw the earthquake and what took place, they were terrified and said, "Truly, this man was God's son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? From the cross, were you there when they took him from the cross? Stone was rolled away. Were you there when the stone was rolled away?
Apostles' Creed at page 96. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Prayers at page 97. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord.
And grant us your
salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us
in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
Custom we pray for our church in this time of transition. Almighty God, you know the needs of your church in every place. Look graciously upon the people of St. James. Grant us the guidance of your Spirit as we move through the search process. We are thankful for faithful stewards you have provided and will provide for our leadership, for the ministry of the search committee, for the vestry in this time. Bless them in their ministries. Give us all discernment, wisdom, patience, and confidence in your timing. Help us to care for each other with mutual trust, respect, kindness, and clarity of purpose. You are the good shepherd, and we ask you to shepherd us through this journey. In the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We pray for the church and the world in this time of health crisis, for our church that it may not grow weary of proclaiming the gospel of Christ, that it may serve as beacon of hope to our suffering world. Remembering Michael, our presiding bishop, Rob, our bishop, Pierce, our interim rector, clergy and staff, wardens and vestry, and all who serve in your name, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for all affected by the virus around the world, for the leaders of nations, that they may work together for the common good. Grant public health and government officials in our nation strength and will to act swiftly and decisively, with wisdom and compassion and service to all, praying for our president and his administration, for the Congress, governors, mayors, and all those who lead in this time. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for healing for those who are sick with the virus. May they have access to the care they need and regain strength and health. Give strength to all who care for loved ones. We pray for healthcare workers who, with hearts of service, stand on the front lines of providing care. Grant them courage and protection as they put the needs of public safety before their own. Bless scientists and researchers as they combat the virus, that their work may yield knowledge to develop a vaccine, treatments, and improve measures to reduce its spread. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for the safety and well-being of all who travel and those who remain quarantined. Remove the presence of fear and anxiety from our hearts, that confident in your providence, we may be generous in sharing resources. Grant that our churches and communities of faith may reflect your love as they minister to the most vulnerable among us. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have already lost loved ones to the virus and those who will yet suffer such loss, that they may know the consolation of your love. And we remember all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints, they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
As we pray for the pandemic health crisis, we pray for the crisis of racial injustice and the need for racial reconciliation, giving thanks for the group from St. James that met last night and asking for blessing on that ministry as it unfolds. Pray for healing in our nation. O God, who can turn our worries into wings of joy and our sorrows into songs of thanks, let not our hearts be so troubled by the tragedies of this life's moment that we lose sight of the eternal life in your kingdom. Give comfort and solace to companions who suffer almost unbearable losses every minute. Strengthen our resolve to replace hatred with love, tension with trust, and selfishness with caring and community. Heal all of our children so that those who hate and those who are hated, those who hurt and those who are hurt, may grow up in a world of peace, opportunity, and justice. Amen.
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 As we offer our prayers for the church and the world, we offer prayers for those known to us in need of God's healing power. As I read our prayer list, I invite you to add names in the column on the right or to say them out loud in a moment.
David, close your window.
As we pray for Adrian, John, Bill, Max, Sarah, Cameron and Henry, Shannon, Maureen, Donald, Stuart, Grace, Delilah, Janet, Judy, Clifton, Pam, and Eric. We pray for Ascension's racial justice effort, Church of Ascension in Manhattan, for Bob Shell, who is in the ICU in Florida, but each day getting better. And we join his wife in gratitude for prayers. We pray for Michael, Jeff, Uncle Fred, and for an unspoken request. We thank you, God, that you know the needs of our heart. We pray for Bob Godley, for Wright and Eileen, for Carl. Are there others you wish to mention at this time? For Ellen, Michael,
Hunter.
And I welcome any Thanksgivings that you have at this time.
For the prayer vigil this morning on the City Hall steps for racial reconciliation.
For rain, which we got yesterday, long overdue.
Hallelujah.
For the participation last night, for the ministry of St. Erin and all that she does for us at St. James.
Thankful for God shattering strongholds that is upon our community.
Grateful for good neighbors.
Amen. Thankful for all of y'all, all of our St. James Parish, all your families.
Pray for Clifton. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. For the means of grace and for the hope of glory, and we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen.
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 Holy and sovereign Lord, when the earth and all its people quake, you hold its pillars firm. What is uncertain and frightening to us is completely known to you and controlled by you. Look mercifully on the people of St. James, although at this time we're apart from each other. We pray your Holy Spirit unite us as one. Pour upon us your peace that passes all understanding. Keep us safe and healthy. And above all, keep us mindful of those to whom we should show the love and compassion of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Bless the Lord. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. And have an awesome day.
You too.
You too.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye, everybody.